My name is Ivan and I wanted to give you a short update about the direct extruder mode I showed you in the previous video. So it was a mode where you were using 3D printed parts basically to put the motor above the hot end and make kind of almost direct extruder. So it was working extremely well. I'm very happy with it. I printed wood, flex, PCADS and carbon with it, all prints went well. I had previous idea to buy the Bontech BMG extruder, but now I'm cancelling it. I'm very happy with this one. So I was looking for how to make the carriage, the X carriage lighter with the direct extruder, because you have this heavy motor that was before on the stock Bowden extruder. And I thought about pancake motors, but when I see their holding torque, I think it's too little with this ordinary extruder. So what I'll be doing is to get the motor from the Z axis, because it's small, it's 36 millimeters, and put it instead of the 42 millimeters motor that is now on the extruder, and then the 42 millimeters will go to the Z axis. So in this way we will have a little bit more power on the Z axis, which is great. So I found this on Thingiverse.
This thing helps replacing the 34 millimeters stepper on the Z axis with a 42 millimeters stepper, the same that comes with the standard Bowden extruder and that we are now using for the almost direct extruder. It installs on the 2040 extrusion frame. It will help us basically to swap this motor and this one. The part is printing right now. I printed this with flex, so it absorbs bad vibrations, if any. Let's swap the steppers now. We'll be right back. I'm quite happy with the new look of my printer. It looks really great. I just hope it will print well. So I'll be testing the printer with a Benchy. I'll be printing it in flex with some extreme settings. The speed will go up to 60 millimeters per second, and I will print with 100% infill just to give it more chance to quark.
Test print of the Benchy. I think it ran very well. Besides some limited stringing, which is maybe normal because I use no retraction and I print with relatively high temperature for flex of 240 degrees. It's perfect. It was printed at very high speed for flex of 60 millimeters per second, and the extruder delivered. I mean, I can only recommend this kind of setup to anyone that has a standard CR-10 printer. It was made with stock components only, so you don't invest in new extruder, in new steppers. It costs nothing. And it's a real improvement over the stock Bowden extruder the CR-10 comes with.